Your fridge is one of the main appliances that you want to keep alive during a power outage. It's something that anyone that has bought a power station or a generator has had to consider, but yet your fridge uses a lot less power than you think. Then every time we bring this up in a video, we have arguments happening in the comments section, people telling us that we're idiots, saying that fridges use excessive amounts of power that we know they don't. Even companies like Solar Reviews, which is a pretty trusted source outside of this one article that we found, has an article saying that a fridge uses 4 kilowatts of power a day, which is insane. So today we ran a test on 3 different household fridges to settle this argument once and for all and share the surprising results with you guys. So here's how a fridge works. Every fridge has a sticker with the rated power. It'll either say volts and amps, or it'll just say the wattage. This is the rated power that the entire fridge and freezer combo will use when it's cooling. So my fridge at home says 115 volts, 3 amps, which means it uses 350 watts. That's the max that it is ever gonna use. If you had it at room temperature and you've just plugged it in for the first time, it'll use 350 watts trying to get really, really cold all at once. Most of the time, your fridge is already cold, and when the compressor comes on, it's just maintaining that temperature. So it uses far less power when it just comes on to maintain, as opposed to when it's actually cooling down for the very first time. And when your fridge is maintaining, I think we can all recall a time where we've sat there and we've heard the fridge come on or turn off. Your fridge isn't always running. It runs for, depending on how hot your house is, how cold your fridge is set to, a fraction of time per hour. So it's using far less power just to maintain, and it's barely even running in the first place. But you don't have to trust me. You can trust the result of our testing. So we tested 3 fridges. My personal fridge is rated for 345 watts. I think I said 350 earlier. It's 345, 115 times 3 amps. When you just go and you plug a power station into the fridge, you can see that it uses basically no power. It's drawing just a tiny bit. Obviously, it's still got to be aware of what's going on, but it's basically nothing. I went ahead and opened the doors. They were open for like almost 45 minutes just to get the compressor to even kick on. And when it kicks on, you can see it's using about 110 watts. So in my case, that fridge, even though it's rated for 345, it only uses about 110. And you can see once you close the doors and the compressor kicks back off, it shows 0 on the screen. Tiny baby's fridge, since he's a tiny boy and he has to make up for it by having big appliances, is actually the beefiest one of the group. His fridge is rated for 609 watts. But same story, if he goes ahead, leaves his doors open, eventually the compressor kicks on to cool it back down, it only uses about 130 watts. The fridge here at the lab is also rated for 350 watts, although this is the most, I would say, power hungry fridge of the group, because it has like the water thing, it's got the ice maker, the front has like a little touchpad thingy, and the lights are always on that touchpad. So this is the only fridge that when it's off, instead of saying 0, it always says like 5 to 15 watts, depending on if it's making ice or water or just powering the LEDs on the front. This fridge always has something going on. Yet it's still a very efficient fridge. Just like the other two, when the compressor eventually kicks on, it only used, I think we saw a max of 110 watts. And so now we know that when it's running, it's using very little. But how do we find out how much power it uses throughout the entire day? If you do the Solar Reviews formula that they have on their article that we've seen a bunch of other places, it basically says take the full rated output, divide it by 3, and times that by 24. So it's basically saying it's gonna use full power for a third of every hour. So if we do that example on the lab's fridge, it's basically saying 350 divided by 3 is 116, times that by 24, it should have used like 2800 and something watts. So we decided to put that to the test too. We went ahead and we plugged in our little wattage, voltage, timer thing. I don't even know what you call that thing. We use it all the time. We went ahead and we used the fridge completely normally. We had the doors open, closed. We were going in and out using the fridge. That fridge left for 24 hours, used a total of 1.3 kilowatts or 1300 watts. 1330, I think, was technically what it used. So in 24 hours, that first equation was way off. And we did that same exact test on Tiny Baby's fridge and my fridge, and they basically all came in at the 1300 watt range. So is that the standard for every fridge? Probably not. If you have a massive fridge or tiny fridge, that can definitely come into play. If you keep your house at 110 degrees, your fridge is probably working pretty damn hard to stay cold. So based on our experience with our 3 fridges that are normal household fridges, we would say that the math shows the fridge runs for about 10 minutes every hour. Basically, instead of doing your full rated output divided by 3, you could do your full rated output divided by 6. 350 divided by 6 is pretty damn close to the hourly usage that it actually took to run our fridge. But the reality is, if you had a Delta Pro 3, you would be able to run that fridge for 3 whole days just off that one unit with no expansion batteries, never charging it up with solar or anything. And so where we live, we rarely get outages that last more than like a day. So even something a lot smaller, even the Delta 3 Plus, would basically keep our fridge on for the entire time that we've basically ever seen an outage. If you live somewhere that experiences outages for much longer time, sure, you're still gonna wanna get a little bit of a bigger unit, assuming you can't just put solar panels outside and charge it. I don't know, maybe you live in Alaska, it's pitch black. I don't know what your life is like. So hopefully this helps you guys understand a little bit better. If you guys see people in the comments that are super confused, just do us a favor, go ahead and copy the link to this video and just comment back with this so that they can watch it and learn, because I don't think that they're trying to be dicks. I think they just don't understand. Anyways, that is all we got for you guys today. Hopefully that helped some of you. We will catch you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.